next chapter is quadratic expressions. This is the third chapter of maths 2A paper, quadratic expressions. So first we'll discuss about the definition. What is quadratic expression? So quadratic expression means the polynomial which is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is called the quadratic expression. The polynomial which is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c, this is called the quadratic expression. Here if a not equals to 0, if a not equal to 0, then only this is said to be the quadratic expression. Quadratic expression, so quadratic means the term contains the x square term. If the polynomial contains the x square term, then only it is said to be the quadratic expression. So if a not equal to 0, then the polynomial ax square plus bx plus c is called the quadratic expression. If a is equal to 0, then what you treat as bx plus c, which is a linear expression. So if a not equal to 0, then this is the quadratic expression. And quadratic equation. Quadratic equation means ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. This is called the quadratic equation. That is, if we take equals to 0 to the expression, then it becomes the equation. Ax square plus bx plus c is called the quadratic expression, and ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0 is called the quadratic equation. And in this equation, this a is called the x square coefficient. This is x square coefficient, and this b is called the x coefficient, and this c is called the constant. This is the constant. And the examples are 2x square plus 3x plus 1. This is the quadratic expression. And 4x square minus 3x. This is the quadratic expression. And x square plus 4. This is the quadratic expression. And x plus 2. This is not the quadratic expression since it doesn't contain the x square term. So this is not the quadratic expression. And the next concept, the 0 of the polynomial. Here ax square plus bx plus, this is called the quadratic expression. Now 0 of the quadratic expression. So the number alpha is said to be the 0 of the quadratic expression if a alpha square plus b alpha plus c is equals to 0. That is, if a alpha square plus b alpha plus c is equals to 0, then this number alpha is said to be the 0 of the quadratic expression ax square plus bx plus c. And if ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0, this is the quadratic equation. And if a alpha square plus b alpha plus c is equals to 0, then alpha is said to be the root of the quadratic equation. That is, root of the quadratic equation means if the number alpha satisfies the equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, then we can say that this is the root of the quadratic equation. In this case, we say that alpha is the root of the equation, and here alpha is the 0 of the quadratic expression. Alpha is the root of the quadratic equation. And the roots of the equation. So here first we take the quadratic equation. Ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0. Now this is the quadratic equation. Now to find the roots of this equation, first I multiply this total equation by the number 4a. That is 4a into ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0. That is, multiplying the values here, 4a square x square plus 4abx plus 4ac equals to 0. And in the next step, we are taking this value as this is 2ax whole square. 4a square x square, that is taken as 2ax whole square, plus this is taken as 2 into 2ax into b. 2 into 2ax into b, which is nothing but 4abx, plus this is in the form of, now this is in the form of a square plus 2ab. Now just I am adding the number plus b square minus b square plus 4ac equals to 0. That is, in between these two terms, we apply the term plus b square minus b square here. Now clearly when we observe that this total term is in the form of a square plus 2ab plus b square. So this total term can be taken as now a plus b whole square form, that is 2ax plus b whole square is equals to, now the remaining two terms are minus b square plus 4ac. Now taking these two terms to that side, then those are taken as b square minus 4ac, which implies 2ax plus b is equals to plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac. Then the value of 2ax is equals to minus b plus or minus, writing this plus b to that side, minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac. Therefore, the value of x is equals to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Now these are called the roots of the quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. These are the roots of this equation ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. So here ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 is called the quadratic equation, and here the condition is a not equals to 0 and discriminant value is delta is equal to b square minus 4ac. So b square minus 4ac is called the discriminant of the quadratic equation and it is denoted by delta. Now depending upon the value of the delta, we can say the nature of the roots. That is, suppose the value of delta greater than 0. If the value of b square minus 4 is greater than 0, then and it is greater than 0 and it is a perfect square. Delta greater than 0 and it is perfect square. Then the roots of the equation are rational numbers. The roots of the equation are rational numbers. That is, this is the first case. If delta greater than 0 and it is a perfect square, that is, if the value of delta is equals to 16 or 25 or 9 or 0 or 4, like that. If we get any value delta like this number, then this is said to be the perfect square. In this case, the roots of the equation are rational numbers. And the second case, if delta greater than 0 and it is not a perfect square. So, delta greater than 0 and not a perfect square, that is, this is a number not like the 16, 25, 904. Means here delta is equals to 15, 17, 18, like that. If you get any value which is like that, 15, 17, 18, then in this case the roots are conjugate sets. In this case, we take the roots of the equation are conjugate sets. Conjugate sets means a plus or minus root b, c plus or minus root d, root 2 plus or minus root 3. These are all the conjugate sets. So conjugate means if a plus root b is the number, then a minus root b is the conjugate of that number. So if delta greater than 0 and it is not a perfect square, then the roots are conjugate sets. If delta greater than 0 and it is a perfect square, then the roots are rational numbers. And in the next case, if delta equals to 0, that is discriminant value b square minus 4ac equal to 0, then the roots are equal and rational numbers. The roots are equal and rational numbers in this case. And the last case, if the value of delta less than 0, that is it is a negative number less than 0, then the roots of the quadratic equation are complex conjugate numbers means already we discussed about the complex numbers chapters. Complex numbers means the numbers which are in the form of a plus ib is called the complex number. Conjugate numbers means the conjugate of a plus ib is a minus ib. That is, in this case the roots are taken as which are in the form of a plus or minus ib. We get the roots in the form of a plus or minus ib. So delta greater than 0 and it is a perfect square, then the roots are rational numbers. And delta greater than 0 and not a perfect square, then the roots are conjugate sets. And if delta equals to 0, then the roots are equal and rational. And if the value of delta less than 0, in this case the roots are complex conjugate numbers. And if suppose alpha comma beta are the roots of the equation, and what is the quadratic equation? Now what is the quadratic equation with alpha comma beta as the roots of that equation? Now we want to find the quadratic equation if these two numbers as the roots of the equation. Then the formula is x square minus x into alpha plus alpha beta equal to 0. This is the quadratic equation with alpha comma beta as the roots of this equation. And the next formula, if suppose ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0, this is the quadratic equation and also alpha comma beta are the roots of this equation, then the formula is sum of the roots alpha plus beta is equals to minus b by a, and product of the roots alpha into beta is equals to c by a. So the quadratic equation, here the quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. The roots are alpha comma beta. Alpha comma beta are the roots of this equation. Then we can take the sum of the roots and product of the roots by using these two formulas. Alpha plus beta is equals to minus b by a, and alpha into beta is equals to c by a. Now these are notes of the definitions. The first point, the polynomial of the form ax square plus bx plus c a not equal to 0 is called the quadratic expression. And the next point, the equation of the form ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, a not equal to 0 is called the quadratic equation. So ax square plus bx plus c, that is quadratic expression. ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, that is quadratic equation. And in both of the cases, a is the x square coefficient and b is the x coefficient and c is the constant there. And the next one, the number alpha is said to be the 0 of the quadratic expression ax square plus bx plus c if a alpha square plus b alpha plus c is equal to 0. And the next definition, the number alpha is said to be the root of the quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 if a alpha square plus b alpha plus c equal to 0. So 0 of the quadratic expression means a alpha square plus b alpha plus c equal to 0. Root of the quadratic equation means a alpha square plus b alpha plus c equal to 0. That is, the 0 of the quadratic expression is same as the root of the quadratic equation. So 0 of the quadratic expression is nothing but the root of the quadratic equation. Both are same. Roots of the equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 or x is equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So those are the roots of the quadratic equation. Now we are using that formula to find the roots of the quadratic equation. And the next one, the quadratic equation with roots alpha comma beta is x square minus x into alpha plus alpha beta is equal to 0. Now this is the formula which is used to find the roots quadratic equation when we have two roots of the equation. Then we use that formula. And the next one, if alpha comma beta are the roots of the equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, then the formula sum of the roots is alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, and product of the roots is alpha into beta is equal to c by a. Here a, b, c are the values which are taken from the given equation. Alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, and alpha into beta is equal to c by a. And the next definition, here the value b square minus 4ac is called the discriminant of the quadratic expression ax square plus bx plus c, and it is denoted by delta. So delta means discriminant. This is nothing but the value b square minus 4ac. Therefore delta is equal to b square minus 4ac. The next concept is nature of the roots of the quadratic equation. So nature of the roots means, are the roots are rational numbers or irrational numbers or conjugate numbers or equal or not equal. These are all depending upon the value of the discriminant. So without finding the roots of the equation, we can tell the nature of the roots by applying these conditions. So here the first condition, to find the nature of the roots, first we take the value of delta, and if delta value greater than 0 and it is a perfect square, then the roots are unequal and rational numbers. Delta greater than 0 and it is a perfect square. Perfect square means the number like 9, 16, 25, like that. So in this case the roots are unequal and rational numbers. And the next case, if delta greater than 0 and it is not a perfect square, means the number is like 3, 7, 10, like that, then the roots are conjugate sets. Conjugate sets means the numbers which are in the form of 2 plus root 3, 2 minus root 3, 2 plus root 5, like that. And next case, if delta equals to 0, delta equal to 0, discriminant value equal to 0, then the roots are real and equal. In this case, the two roots are equal. And the last case, if delta less than 0, then the roots are complex conjugate numbers. Complex numbers means numbers which are in the form of the a plus ib. So conjugate numbers means a plus ib, a minus ib. 2 plus 3i, 2 minus 3i, like that. Now delta less than 0, then the roots are complex conjugate numbers. That's all.